should now read sole source. The second amendment would be to item 10. The amount not to exceed will be changed to $428,384. Third amendment to item 12, which will be funded through the TBA capital outlay account and park improvements account. Item 14, funded through TBA capital outlay account and park improvements account. That is it, Chair.
Okay, we have a motion by Councilman Garza, supported by Councilman Lilly. Is there any other discussion on the agenda? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. May I have a motion to accept the minutes of the meeting held August 15th, 2017, in respect of the oral reading?
Motion.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Myers, supported by Councilman Garza. Any discussion on that? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. And Mayor, did you have anything you wanted to address?
Madam Chair, officially, no. I do have something that I can wait till open business. Thank you.
We'll move on to the regular agenda then. Item number 6. May I have a motion to approve 3 police officers to attend the Michigan Association of Hostage Negotiators 2017 conference in Traverse City, Michigan from October 18th through the 19th for an amount not to exceed $1,500 and that's funded through Act 302 training funds.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Garza, supported by Councilman Willie. Is there any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed? Motion carries. We'll move on to item number 7, which is, may I have a motion to approve 2 canine officers to attend the National Association of Professional Canine Handlers training in Alpena, Michigan from September 30th through October 5th for an amount not to exceed $1,000. This is also funded through Act 302 training funds.
Motion.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Myers, supported by Councilman Mazur. Is there any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 8, we have a motion to approve payment on-duty gear, LLC, which is the sole source for 8 ballistic vests with outer carriers, in an amount not to exceed $2,800 funded through state forfeiture funds.
Motion to approve.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilman Borga, supported by Councilman Myers. Is there any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 9 is a motion to approve the preventative maintenance for emergency hydraulic tools, Jaws of Life, by sole provider of Midwest Rescue Tools, LLC, in the amount not to exceed $2,800. And this is to be paid for out of the Fire Department General Maintenance Fund account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Okay, motion by Councilman Garza, supported by Councilman Myers. Any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 10, may I have a motion to approve the low bid from Hall Fire Incorporated to purchase a fire engine demo pumper in the amount not to exceed $428,384. And this is funded through the Fire Department vehicle account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Johnson. Willie, sorry.
Yep.
No. Warren Johnson.
Sorry. Johnson. Willie. Supported by Councilman Willie. Is there any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 11, may I have a motion to approve the purchase of a shipping container from Container Technology, Inc., which is the low bid, in the amount of $2,650. This is for hay storage container at the petting farm. This will be funded through the General Fund Petting Farm Equipment Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilman Pizzura. Is there any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 12, may I have a motion to approve Messina Concrete, which is the low quote, to provide concrete for 8 dumpster enclosures at 8 locations throughout the city for an amount not to exceed $10,948. That concludes the 10% contingency, and it will be funded through the Taylor Building Authority Capital Outlay Account and the Parks Improvement Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Garza, support by Councilman Johnson. Any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 13. May I have a motion to approve Freedom Contractors, which is local, to prep and replace all rotted wood and paint exterior buildings at Heritage Park Paying Farm. This is for an amount not to exceed $18,172. It includes a 10% contingency, and it's funded through TBA, which is Taylor Building Authority Capital Account.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Gorgon, supported by Councilman Johnson. Any discussion on this item?
Madam Chair, during your study session, we discussed whether this would be a safe paint for the animals.
Right.
Would this amount change if that paint was used?
I don't know if we have an answer to that, but...
Madam Chair, I would anticipate with the 10% contingency that we should have enough to cover, even if there is a slight price adjustment.
Okay.
Just want to make sure.
Thanks.
Madam Chair, I'm not 100% sure. Councilman Myers had that. I just want to make sure to add on.
Right. We'll have to bring it back, but we want to look out for the animals. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 14, may we have a motion to approve Persa County Construction, which was the local, to construct 8 dumpster enclosures at the same 8 locations throughout the city for an amount of not to exceed $51,568. And this will be funded through TBA Capital Outlay as well as Park Improvement Accounts.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilman Woolley. Is there any discussion on this item? Mr. Ramek.
Just a quick question. The contract of the construction of the enclosures, the back on number, I think it was 12, Messina Concrete, they've got a bid for $10,948, and on this one, they're going to construct the enclosures. I was just wondering why we're paying for the concrete. Why was this separated from the initial bid?
Madam Chair, the concrete is going to be done. It's actually just the cost of the concrete. The concrete work is going to be done by our guys at the DPW, and then the contractor here is going to construct it using blocks.
So the concrete won't be used by Persiconia?
No, he's using it.
So we're actually building a platform?
Yes.
Okay. All right, just wanted to be sure. Thank you.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, item number 15, may I have a motion to approve a payment to adult softball coordinator in the amount of $3,710. And this is for the summer 2017 season, and it will be funded through the General Fund Softball League fees.
Motion. Second.
Motion by Councilman Myers, supported by Councilman Gorgon. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 16, may I have a motion to approve payment in the amount of $11,700 to National Faith Home Buyers for the down payment assistance of 2 home buyers, which is numbers 2017-11 and 2017-12, and this will be funded through the home grant.
Motion. Support.
Motion by Councilman Woolley, supported by Councilman Garza. Any discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item number 17, may I have a motion to approve the sale of city-owned property, its vacant property, and its industrial property to Persa County Construction Company, Inc.
so I see throughout the agenda here, low quote, put on several of the items. Is there like a high quote or a high bid for when it comes to selling an asset of the city's?
Madam Chair.
Mr. Mayor.
No, these properties, we discussed it briefly in the study session. The city of Taylor has over 700 vacant properties that we're, number one, not collecting tax revenue on, and we're being charged with the responsibility of maintaining them. There currently is a listing or a link to a listing on the city of Taylor website if anybody wants to bid or make an offer on any of those properties. They're also listed on a service called CoStar, which is available to all local realtors that subscribe to the service. CoStar lists not only city-owned properties, but essentially every property that's available through their network. So they're out there. When an offer comes in, we evaluate the offer, and then the assessor will perform what's called a certified assessment and establish establish a value for that particular property for sale. In this particular case, I believe his established value all in was $78,000. The offer we had was $75,000.
Okay. I'm just trying to understand the process. Thank you.
Very good.
Any other discussion, Mr. Ramek?
Madam Chair, Council, just a quick question. How many acres are we talking here?
I think it was six, wasn't it?
There are six, but approximately half of that is determined to be unbuildable. There's a pond on that property.
Thank you.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.